I was just taking out the rubbish and I see a creature. Let's see if we can get him on video. Oh, what a precious one. Oh, he's in the hole. That's what she said.
I'm finally finding passion again for the things I enjoy, like listening to and playing music after so long feeling depressed.
It's not sustainable and it causes pandemics. I mean, we had mad cow, we had Ebola. This shit is from bats, but the rest of them are from regular animals. Plus, they don't want to die. Animals don't want to die to be 5 minutes in your face. This is it. This is from yesterday morning with the vigil over in Newark. This is a cow who's about to go in and get slaughtered. Listen to him screaming. Like, how can you listen to that and still go to work?
Yeah, they know.
It's just.
For some reason, there was a long period of time where I didn't feel like I deserved to even hear music, and now I'm finally listening to it again. I knew I had a problem because the one thing that brought me the most joy more than anything was no longer something that I was feeling passionate about, and it was really concerning me, but luckily, I'm getting back on track again. There was just a really difficult and lengthy period of time where I was almost just so stubbornly stuck feeling depressed and down that anything that I knew would bring me joy, like listening to music or going socializing or something, I refused to even do because I almost was just way too comfortable feeling down. And when I picked up the book Breaking the Habit of Being Yourself, it really allowed me to figure out how to break that finally. I literally feel like new. Oh my god, fall is coming. I took the Enneagram personality test and my result was type 4. As I looked into the basic descriptions, I felt like it was all too appropriate for myself and my life right now. It said that the basic desire of a four is to find themselves and their significance. And it said that their biggest fear is that they have no identity. Fours tend to feel very different and very much on the outside from other people. It says that they feel they have a very unique talent, but that they also feel they have something uniquely wrong with them that separates them from others. They always feel like something is missing from themselves, which they speculate that it could be self-confidence. It said they also feel like there's something missing from their life, that they can't just be happy and that they envy others in a lot of different ways, but also for the ability to just be happy. It said that fours suffer from chronic low self-esteem, and they may overcompensate for this by having an idealized version of themselves in their head that they strive toward. However, their depression and emotional weight, if they can't get over it and have a structured routine and actually take action on their goals, holds them back from ever being that idealized version of themselves. They find it very hard to be understood by others, but it's the greatest longing to be understood by others, especially in personal relationships. It's basically the tortured artist soul. So I felt like that was a wake-up call in a few different ways. Anyway, we did a new moon ritual. On the new moon, we write what we want to manifest, and on the full moon, we write things that we are releasing and letting go of. The Enneagram test was really interesting. It definitely goes into how you might act based on the things you've been through rather than a personality you were born with. Anyway, I'll link it below in the description. You should totally take it.
So, I don't really have much experience with colored pencil. I feel like you could kind of tell. I don't really know. I was going for some sort of different style rather than just realism. And it was fun. I don't know if I'll do this method again, we'll see.
So I think this is our final little result here. So there you go. Gonna stash it in there with some of my other little drawings lately that I need to frame. Thank you.
Florida in less than an hour and I haven't packed yet, so that's what the fuck I'm gonna do right now. Well, first we're gonna head to Keegan's house to swoop him up, and then we're gonna drive a little bit, probably stay somewhere overnight, and yeah.
We found them on the side of the road.
Mm-hmm. They just let's, happened to be bigger.
Well, ETA. We've got 14 hours to Florida. We're going to stay somewhere tonight, obviously.
No, we're not.
Yes, we are.
We're going to drive right through. No stop.
7 a.m.
Yep.
She left the flash. I know, I didn't realize it.
Going to Richmond.
Oh.
Yep. I'm gonna get rich.
I'm on my bed. I can pretend my soul's gone. I have a light.
How do you feel about our hotel room in North Carolina?
That's pretty good. It's not bad. We've definitely stayed in worse places, said Keegan.
Yeah.
And he's not wrong.
I'm not wrong.
The bathroom's not bad.
It's not bad.
That's what I'm saying. We've definitely stayed in worse places.
Thank you.
jokes is because of the fact that Travis decided to write a book about his experiences. He's definitely become a UFO celebrity in a lot of ways. I mean, he's definitely...
We are almost there.
15 minutes.
We finally made it to Lakeland, Florida, to our Airbnb. Whoa, we got a porch?
We do. Porch in it.
Is this the right place?
There's even a baby swing for you. Look.
Oh, sick. Look at this nice ass porch. Oh my god.
I can feel the cold, literally.
Yeah, I just said that on my video. We should take our shoes off, probably. It smells kind of musty. Wow. Looks like an oil painting, like a real oil painting. Actually, I don't know if that's real. It's totally real. It's the floors feel authentic. Oh, a ghost is gonna sit in this chair and stare at me. I know, I was just seeing that. Oh, what's this? Ooh, the kitchen. Look at the kitchen. It's so cool. Look at the coffee setup. Such a mood. Oh my god. Such a mood. Is that not a mood? Somebody's tracking the height of children. Cute. A guest journal on the dog dick. I'm gonna draw Keegan's dick in the guest journal. Will you pose for me?